Clark, and I'm coming to you from Realtor Plaza in downtown Chicago, right at the NAR building on Michigan Avenue. I know you've seen some of the emails about the updates to the purchase and sale agreement. I just wanted to make sure we were clear on a couple of things. One, there is a new purchase and sale agreement, so down at the bottom in the right-hand corner, look for that revision one. Two, there are only two updates, and they are both on page two, so short and sweet. The first one, if your buyer is choosing to remove their financing contingency, you no longer have to check any of the boxes related to the type of financing. But please remember, that means that if your buyer is removing their financing contingency, they're also removing their appraisal contingency. So if your buyer is getting a loan and they want an appraisal contingency, you'll have to write it into paragraph 17, just like you would with a cash buyer. The second change, also on page two, relates to the availability for the appraiser to get into the property to perform the appraisal. If by chance the appraiser does not have access to the property or the appraisal, then the time for the loan approval period is also extended by the time that the appraiser is denied access to the property. Two changes, page two, purchase and sale agreement. Good to go. Check it out. There's a redline version in MLS. If you have any questions, call me at 904-537-613.